Hi, I'm Jainendra Jain. I am electrical engineer. I worked in L&T for 2.5 years and right now I am working in PSU based on my GATE 17 score. My early engineering in GATE 17 was 827. Today we will learn a topic from power system, which is Faraday effect. What is Faraday effect? When a transmission line is loaded or lightly loaded or on no load condition, the receiving end voltage will be more than the sending end voltage. This condition is known as Faraday effect. Let's say this is our symbolic representation of our transmission line. This source voltage V1, this is the load bus voltage V2, this is our reactance, let's say Jx, and current flowing through this is, let's say, I. Faraday effect says that when there is a no load or light load condition, this receiving end voltage V2 is more than V1. We will see this thing with some mathematical proof. So what you can write here is V2 is equals to V1 minus Jx into I1. Correct. Let's say the power flowing through this is apparent power S is equals to V1 conjugate I apparent power. S is equals to V1 conjugate I. So that S is also S is equals to P minus J Q net. Here we have assumed inductive load. So that this is minus sign, P minus J Q net. What is Q net? Q net is equals to net reactive power which is equals to Q absorbed minus Q generated. Now this Q absorbed is equals to reactive power absorbed and Q generated is equals to reactive power generated. So, and now S is equals to this, from these two equations, what we can write? V1 conjugate I is equals to P minus J Q net. Now here V1 is our reference vector, so that V1 conjugate will be equals to P1. So that I is equals to P minus J Q net divided by V1. Let's say this is our equation 1, this is our equation 2, and this is our equation 3. Now we will substitute the value of I from equation 3 to equation 1. Equals to V1 minus Jx into I1 or I is equals to P minus JQ net divided by V1. Now we will simplify this so that this will be V2 minus is equals to V1 minus JPx divided by V1 plus minus plus, and this J square will be minus, so Q net X divided by V1. So that V2 is equals to V1 minus Q net X divided by V1. We are just arranging this equation, right? So V2 is equal to this. If we draw the vector diagram for this, then this will be like this V1, something Q net, this will be Q net X divided by V1. This will be X by V1 and this will be equals to V2. So here we can see that V2 is derived from the larger part is this V1 minus Q net X by V1, and this PX by V1 is the perpendicular part. So we can ignore this, and so we will get V2 is equals to V1 minus Q net X divided by V1. So equation 4. Right. So till now, what we are doing is we want to prove that V2 is greater than V1. For this, we are deriving some equation so that we can practically prove that how V2 is more than V1. Okay. So one more concept is required here, which we should know is surge impedance loading. First of all, we will write our equation which we have learned here. V2 is equals to V1 minus Q net X by V1, and another one is Q net is equals to Q absorb minus Q generated. Correct. Now we learn about surge impedance loading. SIL. Surge impedance loading is dead loading of line when the line is terminated with a purely resistive load which is equals to ZC. Is known as characteristic impedance or surge impedance of line. Now first of all we see that what is characteristic impedance. Let's say a line is there with resistance, inductance, I mean these are representation of line. This is L, let's say this is C, this is R. Okay. Now in this circuit, the reactive power, there will be two reactive powers. One will be inductive reactive power, which is V square, I square XL. Let's say the current flowing is I, this voltage is let's say V. Then inductive reactive power will be S per XL, and the capacitive reactive power will be V square upon XC. So V is equal to our phase voltage. I is equals to line current, XL is inductive load, inductive reactions, X is capacitive reactance. So XL is inductive reactance, which is a sink of a resistive power. And X is capacitive reactance, which is generally a source of reactive power. So from this equation, I square XL is equal to V square upon XC. If you simplify the above equation, what we will get is V square upon I square is equals to XL into XC, implies V by I is equals to under root XL into XC. Now V by I is equals to under root XL is equals to omega L and XC is equals to 1 upon omega C. So what we will get is root L by C. This V by I is our ZC or characteristic impedance or surge impedance is root L by C. So we have derived one equation of ZC which is root L by C. Okay. And the corresponding surge impedance loading will be, let's say P is equals to V square by ZC. This is our voltage and this is our surge impedance. This loading is V square, P is equal to V square upon ZC. Now, there are two equations. ZC is equals to root L by C, this one. And P is equals to V square upon ZC, this one. Now, what we have defined for Faraday effect was the line is when lightly loaded or on no load condition. In that case, the effect of C will be more in circuit compared to resistance and reactance, inductive reactance. So, the effect of C will be more. So, from this equation, what will happen? ZC will be comparatively less, implies P will be more because ZC is in denominator, so P will be more. So we can say that this is our surge impedance loading. So we can say that when light load condition or when the effect of capacitance is more, then surge impedance loading is more than normal loading of line. So in case of overhead transmission lines, the surge impedance loading is greater than normal loading of line when the effect of capacitance is more. So that what happens also when the C is more, as we already said that C or capacitive reactance is source of reactive power, or it will generate reactive power. So that this is Q minus Q generated. So the value of C is more, so Q generation value will be greater than Q absorbed, correct? If the effect of capacitance is more, the value of Q generated will be more than Q absorbed. So that Q net value will be negative. Let's say Q net is minus Q. We are assuming that Q net it value will be negative. This is the main thing, and we are assuming that negative value is, let's say, Q. So from the first equation, what we can say that V2 is equals to V1 minus Q net X by V1. So that V2 is equals to V1, this is negative Q, so that this will be plus QX by V1. So from this equation we can say that V2 is equals to V1 plus something, so that V2 is equals to greater than V1, which is our concept of current effect, that when the light load condition, the receiving end voltage will be more than the sending end voltage, and this happens when the line is, current impedance loading is more than normal loading. And also this is the case of underground cables, as there will be effect of capacitance more than inductance. Thank you.